Hola, amigo, amigas, señor, señoritas, ladies and gentlemen, dames en heren, dames en heren. Goedenavond en welkom to Channel 48. In this video, we're gonna install Lindroid OS distro the way I posted it, and we're gonna install it on the Dell where it was created on. And we're gonna run into some problems, so I advise you to watch this video very, very carefully so you will understand the complete procedure. So let's get started. Okay, there we are, my friends. We are in the system and I'm gonna open the USB stick because I have a file here, a Lindroid phone mod December for Android phones, and then the thing is themed just about like this system that you see, you know? Okay, so let me think. I think the Lindroid OS should be on. I'm not even sure, guys. So we say goodbye to this system. Goodbye. Ooh. It's off. I'm gonna pop in a stick and let's see what this is. I'm not sure if this is the USB stick. F12. I'm gonna boot from USB. Okay. And this is Lindroid OS version 6.1. Okay, so we're gonna install it. So this will also be the same for Rasta OS. Okay, so you put the USB stick, you boot from USB, you get into the to the live screen, and then you're gonna boot from that USB stick. Okay, we're just gonna let it boot. And there is our beautiful white pigeon on top of the beautiful kind of purple background. Your password will be channel 48 without capitals. And this installer that we're gonna do, that will be install on a legacy device, a device with a legacy BIOS. Okay, so if you're in the desktop, then you can already use the system. You can connect to the internet if your internet Wi-Fi was as well found, the internal, but big chance that it's found. Okay, if not, you will need a little Wi-Fi stick like this one, you know, to do the first installing and to get the drivers for the internal devices that were not found. Okay, so this is the start screen, and the first step that you're gonna do is you're gonna look for Gparted. Just type G and a P and then you're gonna see it, Gparted. So you're gonna start up Gparted. You will need the administrator password, and that's channel 48. Okay. And this is for all my distros the same thing. So I already said you're gonna do this on a laptop that you got for that you got cheap and that has about 2 gigabytes of RAM, or even one if it's a dual core laptop with a dual core processor. If it's some Celeron, then 2 gigabytes is advised. Okay, this is still a 64-bit system, and you also want to run Android that is built in, so 4 gigabytes is beautiful. Okay, so what we're gonna do, let's stay at the lesson. So step one, you're gonna start up Gparted. Yeah, you're gonna see several drives. If you were on Windows, you're gonna see some drives from at least partitions, one from 100 megabytes or 300, and then you're gonna see several. Okay, remember, this step will let you lose each and everything that you had on that computer. Okay? There is no easy installer in my distributions. You must know a little bit about Linux, otherwise, yeah, you should get Ubuntu with the easy installer next, you know? There's nothing like that in here. This is not easy install, but if you get to know this, it's very, very easy. It's easier than the other one and also faster. There's always a benefit when you know how to do something, okay? So what you're gonna do is you're gonna hit delete and delete all these drives, okay? We're just gonna hit delete. No, delete. Here, you can also hit the cross here on top, you see? The little delete selected partition. Okay, and then you're gonna hit the little V there, the green V, and it's gonna delete the complete system. So now this drive, the internal drive of 160 gigabytes, is saying 149, is wiped. All right, so now we're gonna first create partition table, and we say apply. Okay, hey, wait a minute, device. Create partition table, not MS-DOS. Oh, look at that. We can select GPT. So you could also create a GPT partition. For instance, if you have a UEFI device. Okay, we're gonna make a review about that. What I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna create a new partition, okay? I'm gonna create a new partition that will be a X4, and it will be minus, I think we have 4 gigabytes in this thing. I'm not even sure, but it's all good. We're gonna give it a swap file from 4 gigabytes, okay? So we type 4,000 gigabytes here. So that means it's gonna leave some space here at the end, and that we're gonna use as a swap file. So we're gonna say add, okay? You see that? We have here another partition, allocate, unallocated. We're just gonna select for that one, format, or are we gonna say new partition, and that partition we're gonna select swap, Linux swap. You see that there, Linux swap. And then you say add. So now you created two partitions, X4 and a Linux swap partition. The swap represents the RAM in the machine. Okay, now you're gonna hit enter and you say apply. At this point, everything is being wiped from the computer, and at this point there is nothing there, totally nothing. If you're gonna turn on the computer now, if you know, you don't install the OS, it's gonna say could not be found, error, could not find, please select disk to boot from. Okay, so now we hit close, and now we are done with Gparted. Okay, guys, so this was the same procedure as for Rasta OS or any other distribution that I create and that was made with this with SystemBack. So now we're gonna go here on top and we're gonna select the little green thing there, the green round thing that is saying SystemBack. We're gonna select it and we're gonna start it up and we're gonna put in the password channel 48. Okay, so there we go, and now we're gonna hit, of course, system install. Okay, so we hit the system install up here. We're gonna give it a name. I'm just gonna call it Lindroid. Okay, username to log in Lindroid. Oh, I can't stand it. It must have capital at the beginning. Otherwise, oh, I cannot use capitals there. The account password. Okay. At this point, I'm creating a system for myself. So I'm gonna put in my own password. Okay. And so should you. Up here, you should not say channel 48 anymore. And in hostname, you can also call it Lindroid. It doesn't really matter. Okay, now we're gonna hit next. Up here, you're gonna see the two partitions that we just created. I'm gonna bring you a little bit closer. You see that? The first one is saying X4, and we're gonna mount it as root. This little forward slash is root. That means root in Linux partition world. Okay, so you're gonna give that root mount point, and you're gonna hit the little green to change and select these settings to confirm them. You cannot do this one and then confirm and it will do both. No, you must do them one by one. You understand? So here you can see the swap partition that we created. So what should the mount point be? If we look in the list, what do you think that it should be? Swap, of course, all the way at the bottom. And we give a little Roger D there. Now, the most important part of this installing, after you understood the partition, to get everything just the way how it looks in the live system, is to select transfer user configuration data files. You must select it. I selected good, eh? I cannot even see that it's selected. You see that? Now it's selected. So make sure that you select it good. Don't just type here. Make sure that you see the little V in here. If you don't, if you just see that it's black like this, you know, then it's not selected. Click the text and make sure that this little V is there. You see that little thingy that's saying Roger D, you know? And now you can hit next suddenly and you can hit start. So now the system will be installed. This is just a matter of, 5 minutes. And it's just like Microsoft. You know, when
okay, so now the minute you install Microsoft, and we're gonna reboot
and you're gonna
it
connect
really
to the internet, suddenly
see if
you are not able anymore.
Right. Okay, so let's go ahead and reboot the system. And now there is one very important thing that you must remember. This Ubuntu version came with, I think, the Unity desktop or the GNOME desktop. The latest version of Ubuntu 64-bit comes with a different desktop. And I added the Cinnamon desktop. So now we reinstall the system. So, of course, that desktop from Ubuntu will be superior in the installation. And the Cinnamon will be secondary, you know, because this is still Ubuntu. So it's very important that at the login we're gonna select the Cinnamon desktop, okay? And because of this this adding of the Cinnamon desktop, probably we also gonna have one or two or three icons that we will have to fix. Okay, for instance, probably I think the start menu icon will be gone. Okay, but that will be just a matter of right mouse click and then simply select the icon, and then you also know how to change the icon around. So you will also learn something because of that fail. And in fact, it's because this Ubuntu version is, it was not done on Mate, okay? With the Mate desktop, we would not have that problem, because then the Mate desktop would be teamed, and then, in fact, the Mate desktop would be superior in the installation. So you must understand that, okay? So here we are. Be careful now. Don't type the password, like I'm doing now. No, don't do that. Instead, what you should do is hit the little round white little ball there, and then select the Cinnamon desktop and then put your password. You see that there on top? The Cinnamon desktop is now selected. Then you can hit the arrow and then put your password and then log in. Okay, this is only for the people that installed it. And now it's gonna boot into the Cinnamon desktop. But you will find out that after a clean install of the system, that certain little things need to be fixed, okay? Because in fact, Ubuntu was not expecting this desktop to be installed. So certain things, such as you can see there, the start menu, it need to be fixed. So let's fix these things fast, so you can see how that must be done.
Okay. Configure the directory for incoming files does not exist. Configure directory for incoming files does not exist. I don't know what that's talking about. That was Bluetooth. And I see that my
my start menu. My icon is gone.
Yep, that's right. I think that is a problem that we're gonna get if we use the Cinnamon desktop on top of the GNOME desktop. So, but it's really easy. Just hit configure, right mouse click there on the text saying Lindroid OS and then configure. And just go to the home folder. In there, you're gonna find a folder called tools and select start new. Okay, you're gonna see a little icon there saying start new, and then just select it, and then the start menu will be fixed. Okay, so that's really easy. And for the rest, you will see that the dock is also showing only 3 or 4 apps. Just go into the home folder, and there you're gonna find dock apps. Yeah, dock apps. This is a folder that has all the applications that you want to see in the dock. Okay, if you're gonna open it, there they are. As you can see, Audacity, I changed the original icon and affect the cheese as well, and you can see that now it did not automatically find these 3 icons. Okay, so in total we have 4 icons that we need to fix. And the meaning of doc apps folder is when you're in your start menu and you right mouse click application, you can add it to the desktop. Okay, and then from the desktop you just move that shortcut to your doc apps, because you cannot pop in an application into the docky. It's not working in Cinnamon in some way. So you copy everything that you want to see in doc apps, you first add them to the desktop, right mouse click add to desktop, and then you just move them to doc apps, and then you just select them all that you have in doc apps, and you just move them straight up to the dock, and then all the applications will be added in the dock. So yeah, guys, I didn't know that I would run into these problems because of doing this on Ubuntu 64-bit, in fact, Unity or GNOME desktop. I'm not even sure what kind of desktop. I think it's GNOME. Eh? It looks like kind of GNOME. So yeah, we will have to deal with that. Okay, but we still have a beautiful system. In fact, the system is all there, only you must set it up a little bit, and that is a thing that you will have to do with each and every system. However, if you're gonna run it live, then it's gonna be exactly the way I showed it, and probably I find it really sad. If this was done on Cinnamon without Android built in, then in fact we would not have this problem. Okay, this is really a GNOME problem from the I think from Ubuntu, because it is the first desktop. We're just gonna reboot to see if everything went right, but I think everything is just fine now. It will now automatically choose the Cinnamon desktop in the next sessions. So it's just a matter of setting up. You will learn how to change the start button icon. And remember that in your home folder, in the folder called tools, you will find all the icons and things that I kind of used to pimp the system. So if something is missing, you can find it in there. The system sounds are as well in the home folder. Just go to the folders tools, and then you're gonna find all these sounds in there in another folder called stereo, because the sounds you will also have to redirect again, as I learned after the installing. And that also has to do that effect the Unity Ubuntu 18 does not come with sounds. The sounds were not at least maybe they were working, but when I installed the Cinnamon desktop, suddenly I had no sounds anymore, eh? And I could not find no sounds. They were not playing. So that's why I added the extra sound pack, and that sound pack you can find in tools. And it's just a matter of one time setting these things up, and after you set it up, it's just gonna be fine. This what is popping up, I don't know what it is. I'm not using Bluetooth, but it's talking about some incoming folder Bluetooth. I don't know, maybe one of you can look into that, but it's totally not important. Just click it away and yeah, deal with it, okay? I'm really sorry that in Linux Mint I cannot add the grub information of Alien to have Android installed in Linux Mint 19. It's not working. Maybe I should contact a real developer and ask him about how to, you know, if we can still and how to add. Yeah, it's a whole lot of, you know, certain things in Linux I don't want to go into there, because these are crazy commands that you must follow, and this is not easy, you know. So I'm kind of wanting to keep it as much as possible understandable for me, and when I really don't know something, then I, you know, go to the pros and ask them. But here you will find all the sounds, you know, and just go ahead and select these sounds and etc. etc. All right, so that's about this, peeps. We now gonna go to activating and installing the Android, and we need Android 8, so let's connect to the Wi-Fi. Let me show you. Connect real fast to the Wi-Fi, and what you will have to do is download Android x86 version 8. Alternatively, you could also go for another version, I think. Let me see if it at least remembered my settings. Yes, okay, the settings are there. By going to the little black tab here on top, you can make it white and black. So depending on your, certain sites might not show too good with the dark skin, then just put it to light, okay? So what you need to do is go to Android x86.org, okay? That's where you go to. And then up here, you're gonna see the Android 8 RC2. It's just been released. It's very new, okay? And just go to the release. And here you're gonna see it. Okay, and what you do, what you need is the RPM file, okay? But you need the 64-bit, because this is a 64-bit system. And we're gonna save it. Okay, so I'm gonna let this save, and then when this is done, I'm gonna get back to you. Okay, so we downloaded the file. Okay, so the file is now in our downloads. You see that? Android 8, 64-bit. So we close everything now. And now we're gonna go to this little guy here. You see that? That's the terminal screen. Many of you are scared for this screen. Don't be scared. It's a nice little screen. It's so helpful. So what you're gonna type is an old MS-DOS command, CD, and that means change directory. So we're gonna say change directory, and then space to downloads. Don't forget to use a capital for the download, okay? And then it's gonna set it to downloads. And now you're gonna type sudo, that means root, sudo, and then alien space apostrophe, and then psi, and then space, and then what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to your download folder. You click that by going to your home folder here, and then up here you're gonna find, of course, your download folder. It's so easy, it's so easy. And then you're gonna right mouse click this file, right mouse click it, don't delete it, or you can hit rename. You hit rename the file, and then you go and stand behind the RPM, and then you select the complete name of the file. So you select the complete everything, and then you say copy. So you copy the exact name including the RPM of this file. Alrighty, and then you're just gonna go back to your terminal screen and you right mouse click and then you hit paste. Of course, now it will ask you the password of this computer, because you said sudo. You said sudo root, I am the boss and I want Alien to push Android into the system and create a dual boot. So we say enter and it's asking for the password. So we put in the password. This is of course your own password, huh? And then you're gonna see no activity. You're gonna see nothing at all. Okay? And we're just gonna leave it for a while like that. And I'm just gonna let it go. Okay? And when I see that it's doing something, I'm gonna get back to you, because this takes about 5 to 10 minutes. Here we go, process started. You will see failed to remove Android, blah blah. Don't worry about that, that's totally not important. More important is that it's saying found image boot, blah blah blah. You know, found this, found that, generating grub configuration. If you see no errors here, then you're good to go. So now we just installed Android. So we're gonna say sudo reboot. And then it's gonna reboot the system. Okie doke. And I must type hit escape, and there you see, by hitting escape, sorry, you cannot see anything, sorry for that. Here you can see, by hitting escape, we can now as well start up Android. Android will not run on this system because, in fact, Android 64-bit is not running on this laptop. This laptop cannot run any version of 64-bit. It doesn't matter how you're gonna install it. It's gonna get stuck here somewhere. And I don't know what that is. It will not continue. But on your system, it will continue just fine. If your system can run Android, you know, it will continue. The 32-bit works fine on this system. But this is something with Android. Android don't like this Dell. Okay, but for you it's just gonna start up and yeah, you will be booting Android. All right, in my case it's not working, but this machine is fine to create a system that will work for somebody else, so it's not about that. So yeah, we're just gonna let it boot. It's gonna automatically boot back into Lindroid OS, Ubuntu Lindroid OS, of course, Ubuntu Lindroid OS, very important. Ubuntu is big part of this all. This is done on the Ubuntu operating system. And in fact, yeah, maybe I had to, yeah. Maybe next time I must just do this on Mate again, okay? Maybe the challenge was a little bit too big to do this on the Cinnamon desktop, because yeah, this system officially does not come with the Cinnamon desktop, so of course the thing is then gonna add its own launcher as the first and as the, you know, with the highest priority. So it's very important after you install to just select that little white ball and make sure that it's set to Cinnamon, because it's gonna set it to Ubuntu default. In fact, I want to delete all these desktops. So I want to create a new version of Ubuntu without all these desktops installed, without Ubuntu default and Ubuntu on Wayland. You know, so when I install a desktop, that it will only know that desktop, and then in fact everything should work. Then my files should at least, yeah, I'm not sure, maybe that's just how it is with this build.
Because I never had that before, that I had to, you know, in the beginning, because I forgot to add folders, but now not anymore, you know. Now all my systems work out of the box and they work fine, at least on Linux Mint. But I cannot push Android into Linux Mint. So let's see what is this. Please make sure directory home Lindroid OS v6 downloads exist. Oh, it does not exist. Oh. Let's go to home. Downloads exist. What are you saying? It does not exist. I don't know. That's crazy warning. So somebody look into that for me. What that is, it's not an important problem, I think, not at all. So the system works nice. Let's open up iTunes and see if all these applications still work fine or if suddenly they don't work anymore. I don't see it booting. So what happened? Oh boy. I'm gonna Ubuntu. What did you do to my thing, man? Crap. iTunes. This is a total fail. Error running cool edit. Failed to change. What? Failed to change. What is it saying? C program files. No such file or directory. Nothing works. Oh my god, this is the biggest fail ever. This is terrible. Wow, Ubuntu. Q for wine. Where are all my applications? Oh, here they are. Cool edit. Nothing works. This is a total fail. This is a total fail, my friends. Kodi should work. Kodi works. Oh my god, this is a total fail. I never had this before. I feel awful. Virtual DJ also not works. Wine is, I don't even see Wine. Wine CFG. Q for Wine. Run iTunes. No. Auto start. Run. This is terrible. This is terrible. This is total fail. None of my oh, I find this really sad. So let's browse my C drive. God allemachtig. Gosh allemachtig. Dit is toch verschrikkelijk.
Dat heb ik nooit eerder gehad. Het enige wat Ubuntu dus goed kan, dat is die... Jezus Christus, hij zegt, hij. Och, dit is toch verschrikkelijk. De maas pora het oorigimja. Hé, Assans, nou, is het total veel, man. I'm ashamed. I feel ashamed now. So, damn it. Why did Ubuntu not like Linux Mint just integrated these packages? Why was it? Should they all be installed again? Oh my god. Okay, let's see what actually happened. Okay? So we must install all these applications again, I think. Oh, this is terrible. Well, it's not so terrible, Puck. Let's see what's gonna happen. Auto start. So, yeah, what should I do here? What is this? Oh, repair. Yeah, repair. Okay, there we go. Installing iTunes, repair. So, I will make a zip of these files for you. In fact, I can include, I feel a little bit bad, but on the other hand, it's also not bad, because we did create a system with Android built in. So we have that system is built in. It's just that Wine and Ubuntu do not agree to, you know, go ahead and let the applications work after an install with System Back. That while with Linux Mint, everything works. I don't have no apps that don't work, only with Ubuntu, as I can remember now. So I'm gonna open iTunes. Let's see what happens. Probably this shortcut is not good. So let's find it from here, iTunes. So which one do I need now? Maybe the second one? The first one. Yay! Okay, so... Yes. Just hit OK. So you will have to, even though it's saying all these things, not properly installed. Oh god, rot toch op met je bonjour service, joh. And don't show this message again, no. Let me see if it works. Yeah, this is all a little bit different. I don't hope it's gonna quit. No, don't ask me again. Don't download. Go away. So, let's close this. And let's open some radio station. I hope it's not gonna quit. No, it's not quitting. Okay, so this is good. So we learn, eh? I'm also learning from my own creation now. So I hope you... I'm also not a professional, eh? Even though it looks as if, you know, I'm not. So, okay, this works. So, yes, peeps, unfortunately, you then have to remove this icon. And then you must remember that iTunes...
that this first one is the icon that you need. Oh no, right mouse click, add to desktop. Okay, so this is the story. You add it to your desktop and then you go to your home folder. And here you're gonna see Dock Apps and you're gonna put it into your Dock Apps. Okay, there it is. Hey, it's showing two times, but only one works. So I think this is the one that works. Or was it the other one? It was this one. Don't show this message again. No. So that means we need this one. You see that? It's kind of confusing. Eh? The thing is installed two times now. And one is working and the other one is not working. So that is, yeah, a little bit sad. So I'm gonna move this one to trash. And I'm not sure if I can delete the other one. iTunes. Uninstall. Uninstall quick. No uninstaller there. Uninstaller. Let me see what's there. So effect, we had to first uninstall, but I don't even see iTunes. Let's see, Apple software update, probably that is the iTunes. Mobile device support and application support. To tell you the honest truth, friends, I don't know.
And neither do I care. We installed the system, everything works. I will have to install the Windows applications again. As you can see, they are not working. You could hear my disappointment in the video. But I'm over it now, and I think this distro is still very good. But I'm gonna remake it, and I'm gonna do it on the Ubuntu Mate. So, yeah, that's it. I want to thank you for watching this long, maybe boring video. I'm not sure how you experienced it. If it was of any help, leave it a thumbs up. If not, leave it a thumbs down, of course. And I hope that in my next distro, I won't be running into these problems again. For you, this weekend, stay safe. Have a fine one. Enjoy it with your family. And if you're alone, be very nice to yourself. See you in the next video again. Until then.